Today, I have here with me Dr. Sri Kumar Padmanabhan, who is an inspiration. He is a medical doctor by profession and a prolific self-taught painter by passion. Having nearly been in Qatar for over 14 years, Dr. Sri Kumar has been spreading positivity with his colors and creative strokes as long as he can remember. Dr. Sri Kumar, welcome and thank you so much for being a part of our show.
Thank you, Shamin, for the lovely intro. Thank you for having me.
Thank you. I have been going around your house and your paintings are phenomenal.
Thank you.
The colors, the shades, the detailness that you've used, they all come together and make it a masterpiece. So I want to know more about your journey as an artist.
Yeah.
Please tell us, what was your first experience with art?
I started painting at the very young age of maybe 3 or something. My mom says like I started painting even before I started talking. Like I used to scribble on whatever paper, whatever I got, you know, on my hand, animals and landscapes. Like later I started to copy pictures from comics like Amarjit Prakata and magazines, calendars and all. And then like I was really lucky to see Raja Ravivarma paintings directly because my family had connection with the royal family of Travancore.
Oh, nice.
So I used to visit Kavadiya Palace quite frequently and I had the good fortune to see Ravivarma paintings directly. Of course, those days I never knew it was Raja Ravivarma.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe that clicked something in me. And from that time onwards, I was so much attracted to painting. So I always knew like I will be painting. And but once I went to school, of course, studies took a foreseat and I was painting less because I was more focused on my studies. And once I reached my medical college, I started participating in a lot of youth festivals and I won some prizes that boosted my confidence.
Nice.
And then I, you know, continued my journey and now I'm painting more and more. That's it.
That's great. So you became more active with painting during your medical college days.
Yes, during medical college and after becoming a doctor. Yeah, I'm more active as a painter also.
That's
yeah.
Usually is the other way around.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
And you never had any formal classes or training?
No, I was never, you know, like lucky to have a formal trade, like, you know, teacher to teach me. But like I get like inspiration from lot of like I think again I'm lucky that all the great artists like
right.
Starting from Bugro to Da Vinci, from Michelangelo and Raja, all are my teachers. You know, I get inspired, I learn from their techniques, and so they are all my teachers.
This is nice. This is truly a talent. So doctor, you've been in the profession for over 25 years.
Yeah.
How did you find the right balance between maintaining your passion and practicing medicine?
Yeah, I was expecting that question. Well, it is really difficult to balance both you know, this passion and profession because my job takes around 11 hours of my daily life. I have to, you know, travel to Dukan and Raslapan at present. So like I drive around 2.5 hours, I'm on the road and then my job is around 8 hours.
Wow.
And of course there are some, you know, I have taken some courses, studies, I mean, you know, classes. And then once I come back, of course there are family commitments. And I spend around 1.5 hours in the gymnasium. I'm a sort of fitness freak. So after everything, I have to find time for my art, which I try to do as much as possible. For me, like doing painting is like a yoga therapy, you know, it totally, you know, cools me down.
Right.
Once I'm in my studio, I paint, I forget everything. It makes me, you know, so happy. You know, I forget everything. So it's again everything about time management.
Correct.
How it is possible. Maybe it's not always possible every day, but I try my maximum. And I have never separated myself as a doctor or an artist. I have always been an artist. So it is nothing new to me. So I'm not exactly balancing or forcefully doing it.
Mm-hmm.
This naturally comes to me. Like, you know, it's like a daily routine to me.
Whenever you feel like...
Yeah, almost like just... sometimes even like we have to go out for a party and my, like, you know, wife is getting ready and I you know, I'm ready. And I get some, you know, sometime, even 10 minutes, 15 minutes, I quickly
go to
the
studio
and do something, you know. That's something naturally comes to me. I don't have to, you know, do something extra for that.
Right.
That's it, yeah.
That's nice. So how would you describe your art?
My art, see, I told you before also, I'm not formally trained.
Mm-hmm.
So I started, you know, drawing like animals and landscapes. And later, once I started making human figures, like portraits, and I started getting the face look like a face, I got so thrilled. So Then I started looking into like great artists like Raja Ravi Varma and Bugero, Da Vinci, Michelangelo, Reynolds, Rembrandt. So like I got inspiration from all these artists, and I initially started copying their works, you know, so they are like my teachers. So first I started copying them and tried to make it as much as possible, you know, as much I can to their art. And then I knew that I got some of the techniques, then I wanted to make my own paintings. So for that, I used to collect photographs from, you know, and I had a big scrapbook. Okay, so maybe it's like cuttings which I see in the newspapers or magazines. I take photographs, and I have a lot of photo, you know, photograph of friends. They used to give
mostly
me
mostly portraits.
Yeah, portraits and even, you know, landscape, whatever it is. You know, like, you know, there are a lot of my friends here who are photographers. I ask them for good photographs.
Yeah.
So they give it to me, and I make a scrapbook. And whenever I feel like that, I start making pictures. So I need a reference because I am not trained. So I need a reference.
Right.
I use them for my my images. So this is how I used to make. So again, I my technique is mainly like you can tell based on like ancient, like, you know, old European academic art or Renaissance style of art. It's not at all modern art. It's very, I can tell it is very simple and straightforward. There is nothing ambiguous to it. It's very beautiful, colorful, and of course it will convey a message, but it's very straightforward.
So all those were your inspiration, and also your trip back to the palace. Can you tell us more about?
Yes, you know, like, of course I have been like I have been traveling a lot since the last 14 years. So I each different countries, you know, we visit, we find something new. Okay, so that inspires me, and I'm a big movie buff. So when we see movies, and even like, you know, I read books. So sometimes when you read books or hear a poem or a song even, so that song inspires us to, you know, make a painting. And I have made paintings based on songs.
So you create a mental image.
And like I then research for like, you know, search for images which will go with that song, and I have created paintings based on those
That's great.
And I asked my, previously I used to ask my mom to pose for me. And now my wife is like, she's my model and muse. So you can see her in most of my paintings. So she's my model, permanent model.
So Dr. Sri, as you know, some people prefer turning passion into profession. So what are your thoughts about that?
See, well, about me, if you're asking, I never separated myself from an artist and or a painter and a doctor, because I became a doctor at the age of 24, okay, when I passed my major, and I have been painting since I remember. So for me it was not a separate thing, and I always knew like I'll be painting because I knew. So of course it's a difficult thing to you know, follow your passion, and you, because you don't know whether you are going to be successful or not. And that's why most of the people try to choose a successful profession. Okay, for me, in my case, I was fortunate that I was successful as a doctor, and I can't tell that I'm successful as an artist, but at least, you know, I'm doing what I love doing. So I can't stop being a doctor, because this is something I really love doing. I think I'm equally passionate as a doctor. And I feel very much fulfilled being a doctor, because I can serve the my society, which I really, of course, love.
Okay?
And I'm happy to do that. And at the same time, once I do paintings, it is sort of like my self-expression. And it is my mind and my personal space.
Your peace.
My peace and my personal space. And I feel very much sort of accomplished. So I don't know how to explain that. It is it's a difficult question. You have to, it's a difficult thing to balance again.
Right.
That's it.
I guess people have their own ways of interpreting it.
Again, you have to be lucky. You know, sometimes, you know, your profession and passion becomes one. Okay. For me, you know, it is two.
Yeah.
But again, as I told, my profession also is a passion. I always want to become a doctor. From time I think I reached my 7th or 8th grade, my aim was to become a doctor. So I was very passionate about that.
Okay.
And I, even that time I was painting. So I never knew that that artist is something different. It's sort of risky taking painting as a profession. Right.
Your focus and passion were.
Yes, yes.
You were very determined.
Yes, yes, that's
since the beginning. So this is your beautiful gallery with your paintings. So doctor, apart from oil painting, what other kind of paintings have you explored? What is your favorite?
Okay, well, as anyone else, I started with watercolor. Then I graduated to poster colors, acrylic. And since I think last around 8 years,
right.
I'm doing oil painting. And once I started doing oil painting, I can't do anything else. I'm, you know, so much addicted to oil painting. See, this is an oil painting one. This is oil painting. Father Amir, this is an oil painting one. This is acrylic,
right.
But I dab with oil, charcoal, acrylic. I think most of the different mediums are there. I like working with all mediums, but my favorite is oil. These are all oil paintings because it really has a depth and life to it.
Right. So where can we find your art around Qatar?
Okay, see, this is my, in my house itself, you can see around 50, 60 paintings all around my house, my personal gallery. But as in, I don't have any public display of my paintings, but some of my paintings have been purchased by art collectors here in Qatar,
okay.
In the US, in Australia and India. So like, they are personal art collectors. And I think a lot of my friends have my paintings in their houses. So around 50, 60 paintings are outside. And that is it. Like,
yes.
I don't have a personal, like, you know, public gallery.
That's fabulous. So how many paintings have you done so far?
Oh, I have really lost count of that. I think I have made around 2,000 or 3,000 paintings.
Oh wow.
So far, yeah.
Have you had any art exhibitions in Qatar?
In Qatar, I have done surely around 36 to 38 art shows. I have done definitely 14 or 16 solo exhibitions and have been a part of so many group exhibitions in Qatar. I think I have participated in 8 or 10 group exhibitions in Qatar,
okay.
And few in Qatar Foundation and one or two in Fire Station Museum and one in Sheikh Faisal Museum and various other places.
Mm-hmm.
And we have an organization called Visual Arts Forum India, WAFI. It's under the Indian Embassy.
Nice.
Okay. So we also have organized some workshops and some for the kids, school kids, and also we had done various shows.
You do some local exhibitions also?
Yeah, local exhibition in the schools to inspire kids, you know, like some those
that's
work
nice.
We do, yeah.
So it's like giving back to the community,
yeah.
Through your work.
Yes, yes. So, and even other GCC countries also have done some exhibitions, and
okay.
In India also one or two, that's it. But mainly it is in Qatar.
Right.
Yes, yes.
So from what I see, your paintings are exceptional and brilliant. I know it must be hard for you, but can you tell us your top three paintings that are very close to your heart?
See, whenever I do a painting, after some time, it falls from, I know I have to work more on that. It is never up to what I expected.
Yeah.
But still, if you're asking me about my top favorite, still, okay, see, this one. This is a reproduction of a famous painting by Raja Ravi Verma. Of course, it is not my work. It is a reproduction of my guru, actually, Raja Ravi Verma. This painting I have done, I think, around 6 or 7 times. Okay.
Oh.
So I'm trying to perfect it as much as possible. The original painting is in Sri Chitrangal Art Gallery in Trivandrum. So where, you know, you can't go and take a photograph of the painting. So I went to the gallery once. And I stood in front of the painting for almost 1 hour see the painting, to imbibe the
mental image.
Yeah, the nuances of the, you know, the colors he had used. It's much bigger than this. It's almost 1/3 more than this painting. And while I was watching, the curator came and asked, why this guy is standing in front of the painting for so much time? Who are you? What are you? And I told him, see, I want to see the painting. And they told, no photographs. I told, okay, fine. Because, you know, if you check on the internet, you can find the images, but it's not like this. The colors, everything is different.
Right.
So I wanted it to be as much close to the master's work. And I spent almost 1 month on this painting. Initially, I made the outline 6 years back. Then I couldn't do it. I didn't have the proper mindset for that. Last year during COVID, 1 month, I totally dedicated to this. And I felt like when I was painting, literally Raja Rivarma was behind me, you know, guiding me to do, you know, mix this color, do this. And like, even like I'm after my work, I'm trying to take a nap.
You're thinking about the painting.
I want to go for it. Even in my dreams, I'm, you know, making the leaves or the swan. So it was totally into me. And still now this is one of my top favorites. Another favorite till now. I think this is my third or fourth oil painting. Why this is personal to me is like, this was a photograph taken by one of my friends, photographer friend, Biju Raj. This is a child left to beg on the temple premises. I saw the photo. I usually don't try, you know, paint much negative paintings, images. But this somehow caught my attention. Like, you know, I wanted to paint it immediately. Right. Actually, that day I didn't know Biju much. I became his friend. I asked for his permission and I painted it. You know, again, this came too much from my heart. So still now, this is one of my favorite paintings. Yeah. And there's a third painting which I'm doing now, which is sort of a commission work. It is a painting about a Gandharva. It's a celestial musician, dancer and warrior, which of course there is no reference image. I have been referring so many different images and I'm trying to, you know, get inspiration from my masters like Bugro and Ravi Varma.
So everyone has their own ideas of
this. Yeah, you know, of course, there is no typical image like what I'm drawing and painting now. I'll show you that in my gallery, in my workshop now. It is still upcoming, but now that is my current favorite because since the last 4 weeks, I'm spending on that.
Oh, wow.
You can see that in my workshop.
So that painting is taking about 4 weeks, this painting about a month. How long do you usually take to complete a painting?
See, it is not about the time of the painting. See, previously I used to finish the painting on one go. Now, I don't need to do that.
Right.
I want to achieve as much perfection as possible from me. Sometimes it may take like weeks to finish a painting. And I stop the painting after 2 days, 3 days, I come back and see, I know, okay, I have to correct it. There are some paintings which after months I again correct it. So it is not about the time of the painting. But sometimes if I'm doing acrylic work, I finish it that day. I want to finish a painting. There are paintings which I have started on one night and by early morning I finish it.
Are
works like that also. So it is again not about the timing or like how much time you took for the painting.
So you're a perfectionist.
Sort of.
You like to improve
every time. Yeah, I like to improve. I don't know whether I reach perfection, but I like to improve. Like, you know, that's always, you know, it's again about the beauty and the balance and whether we are able to. It's not about the, you know, the external thing. It's about whether there's a message in each of the paintings. This is, you know, the swan coming and telling the princess about the prince. So the princess should have, you know, that sort of nostalgic or that romantic feel in her eyes when she's hearing the story.
Right.
So if the image is not giving us that feel, it is lost. It's not just about the external beauty. You know, this image should show that the child is sleeping and the bottle is left, the money is there. So, you know, some sort of simple, you know, I don't need any complicated message, some simple messages, but it should be easily
emotions,
conveyed. Yeah, it should be easily conveyed. That's what I'm looking into.
I would love to see your latest work that you're working on.
Yes, sure, sure. So it is still under construction, but we can see it. Yeah, sure.
So this is currently your painting in progress, one of your favorite paintings.
See, my favorite keeps on changing as I told you. So this is one thing I'm working on recently. This is a Gandharva or a celestial singer, musician, warrior. There is no particular image like this. So this is all from my imagination. Not imagination, actually I'm referring so many paintings from so many images actually, you know, even for the backdrop, the person, the tamburu, the way he's chanting, his posture. So you know, there's no particular image. Actually, even I asked my son, my friends to stand for me, you know, in a particular way. So it's what is coming in my mind. I'm trying to make it as better as possible because there have been some famous painters who have done Gandharva paintings. And this is like a tribute to my masters, Raja Rivarma and Bugro, whom I admire a lot, actually. I think if you are asking me my one favorite painter, that is the 19th century French artist Bugereau. So this is mainly on his style. Okay, it's that European academic artist style. So this is one of my favorites, yeah.
So looking at all the paintings in the studio, it's remarkable how realistic your paintings are, right? So as viewer, I feel like a certain connection with them because of all the human emotions that you've stroked with your magic hands. So tell me one thing, do you always paint around a certain theme, or is there a specific message that you always revolve your paintings around for the viewers and the community?
No, I do all different type of works. Like, you know, I have done commission works on, you know, if people tell, you know, they want their parents painting or their kids painting, I have done that, like straightaway portraits, you know. I have done like famous personalities, I have done Father Emir, I have done our Emir's painting.
Right.
And at the same time, like, you know, I feel like, you know, I have to do a painting showing a certain message. Okay, something is happening in our world, I want to put that image to that.
Yeah.
Or I read a story or hear a poem and I want to make a imagery out of that, I start doing that. I make a mental sketch out of that, and I of course take some references. I start putting paint into that image, but I always have a idea how it should be at the end. So till it reaches there, I don't stop. So in between, maybe I feel that that impulse is not there, or that thing is not there, I stop. And then maybe I revisit the painting after a few weeks or even months, and I redo on that. And if it is not coming up to my even, I totally, you know, wipe off the painting. So I like to strive for perfection, and at the same time, see, it's not only about the physical appearance of a painting. It's about like the message, you know, what we are trying to convey. So most of my painting, even though it is very straightforward and simple, I like to the viewer should understand, see, this is the message the painting is giving, not only the external beauty but a simple message. That's what I'm trying to convey.
And the detailness that
of
you
of course add, the detailness is important.
This.
It is important.
Right.
Yeah.
This is beautiful. This is nice. So doctor, you've been in Qatar for around 14 years. So from your experience, how has Qatar created opportunities and helped artists like you?
See, I think Qatar has been very lucky for me as a doctor, as an artist. For me as a doctor, my career really flourished, my studies actually really, you know, took a different turn when I came to Qatar. From here only, I took my all of my higher education, my master GP and my diploma in occupational health. Most of my higher studies I did while I was in Qatar. And regarding my art side, see, our government, Qatar government, has done really a lot to encourage artists here. We have our Qatara, Qatar Cultural Village. I have been part of the Fine Arts Society there, building number 13, and so many other associations there. And I have been exhibiting my works there regularly since 2014. And so many exhibitions have been conducted by the various departments there to encourage artists locally as well as internationally. So many international exhibitions have been held. Similarly, Fire Station Museum, Qatar Foundation, and even now even Qatar Foundation is doing a show to like focus on MF Hussain, the artist from India.
Okay.
So like Qatar is not differentiating between a local artist or artist from another country. For them, it is just art.
Right.
Okay. And so they are seeing it equally, and definitely for us, it is a big blessing. It's a boon to be here, to get this much encouragement. I don't know whether I would have, I would be getting this type of encouragement in any other country if I have been. Even in my country, I don't know. But I'm so lucky to be here. And with these shows, even in these exhibitions, we are able to interact with so many international artists.
Correct.
And like so much networking to study from those. So like we are doing a great job.
Right. You also found your own artist community.
Yes. We made our own artist community, like that Visual Arts Forum India, which, you know, it is a non-profit organization. We are at least trying to get together Indian artists to do something for the Indian community.
Right.
It's not really Indian community we are doing for poor possible.
Right.
That's it, yeah.
That's brilliant. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
I was in conversation with Dr. Sri Kumar about his wonderful journey as an artist. I shall be back next episode with a different story at Stories from Qatar. Until then, keep following Kathare on Instagram and Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel as well.